David, you've argued that the green shoots theory, that the various improvements in economic indicators that we've seen recently show that the global economy is improving. This week we've seen the S&P 500 break the trend line resistance and the 200-day moving average, and it's going higher. Are we seeing a recovery or not?
We're seeing a general reflation theme in the economy, and the general expectation among investors is that the central banks will be able to reinflate the economy. That's why we're seeing commodities going higher, the dollar is going lower. We're seeing stocks going higher, treasury yields are rising, anticipating higher inflation. We're seeing the break-even inflation rates also breaking higher, and now running at around, well, above 2%. That's the average expected inflation over the next 10 years, massively higher from the past 3 or 4 months. So that's a general reflation theme, and the belief is certainly not that we will have deflation. And if that happens, it will only be a very short time period.
So, in the medium term, what do you see happening?
In the medium term, I think the stock market will, well, if we look at the next 3 or 6 months, I think the stock market will peter out of strength. And that could happen sooner rather than later, because the expectations that have been built into the stock market at these current levels for earnings will most likely be very much disappointed going forward. I think it's the expectations are far too rosy with regard to the earnings growth.
Okay. Texas Instruments revised its expectations upwards this week, and that's helped the tech stocks especially. Do you think fundamentals will come through or not?
I think that we do have a lot of a lot of single stories out there where things are really not as bad as feared, but on aggregate, I think the expectations will be disappointed. And actually, I believe that'll be especially the case for tech stocks because they are very vulnerable to demand contraction in the on the investment horizon mm-hmm. because they're very much producing to other corporates, and that's where we are seeing the most serious contraction in spending right now.
Okay. I mean, in terms of consumer spending, there have been one or two surprises recently. Is there any grounds for hoping that consumer spending will increase again? There's a lot of money out there at the moment.
No, I don't think so. I think the optimist side of the camp right now is arguing that we can basically take like a movie, just a look at the data series and clip out or cut out 12 or 18 months of crisis that we are now through, and then mix it together and look at this time series and say, okay, now we couldn't see any blip. We didn't have any change. We couldn't see anything happened. That will not happen. I think that's completely unrealistic. We have built excesses, and I would argue this has been going on for the past 30 years. And of course, they have been very much culminating in a very excessive culture, and with the whole way that debt has been perceived at the top of this cycle has been very much extreme. And we will now go in the opposite direction, in the complete opposite direction. We'll have massive deleveraging that is already happening. At least consumers, households are trying to deliver, but the problem is that they are now cutting debt, and they are successful at doing that, but their assets are actually decreasing faster in value than their debt. So the leverage in the total system is, at least in the household sector, is actually increasing, and at the same time, especially because the federal government in the US, all governments in the world basically, are adding to the debt. So the whole system is now even more leveraged than it was just 6 months ago. And this is not a way out of the current problems that were caused by excessive leverage.
Okay. Is there a way out of this situation?
There is a way out. We will be forced to take it, whether we like it or not, whether we'll try in the short term or we'll try and postpone it. The way out is either to default on the debt, either we're talking about government debt, household debt, corporate debt, or we'll have to just pay it off by old-fashioned hard work. And it seems that policymakers are very much keen on postponing this until the creditors will basically no longer refinance their debt, or they will simply just cut them off and say, we want our money back, we won't finance you any longer. And that will become an extremely unpleasant situation if they're forcing us out there. Instead, we could actually take control of the situation. We could say, okay, we definitely don't want to add to the debt, so we need to cut the government spending, we need to cut personal consumption and also corporate spending, and make sure that we can have some honest productivity gains in especially the corporate sector again, and especially actually in the government sector, because there's certainly a lot to be cut there.
Yeah, okay. I mean, just to go to the bond situation at the moment, there has been a big sell-off this week. Could you explain a little bit about what's happening there?
Well, there are basically two explanations. One is that the inflation expectations have been going higher, and certainly that is some of the reason. But the nominal yield has been rising faster than the Treasury inflation protected securities yield, which indicates that the risk premium has also been rising, not only in the past week, but over the past 2 months. Yields have been going much higher because foreigners don't want to be vulnerable by owning long-term debt securities in the U.S. because they are spending so much money now, and they're not showing any signs of being responsible and making the hard choices that President Obama was promising in his election campaign. So they want to get out of the long-term debt and get into the short end of the curve, which is definitely what we're seeing right now, because mm-hmm. the bid cover ratios in the auctions in the short end of the curve have been rather sound, but the participation of foreigners has been increasing, showing that their demand for short-term debt is rising while their demand for the longer-term debt is on the decline.
Okay. David, thanks a lot.